Good morning, Seguin High. This is Kelsey Benich.
And Brittany Miner with the MATcast for Friday, September 7th,
2012. Girl, what you
consisted of celebrity makeups, breakups, Olympic golds, and a few other tragedies along the way. Now here is your summer recap. While Call Me Maybe was the song of the summer, the Olympic athletes were listening to music to pump themselves up for their respective events. The gymnastics girls qualified for the first time since 1986 in the gymnastics all around. Gabby Douglas got a near perfect score, claiming gold in the gymnastics Olympic singles. And last but not least, Michael Phelps claimed an Olympic and world breaking record 21 medals. In total, the U.S. brought home 110 medals. In other news, Kristen Stewart and Robert Pattinson's relationship was not as triumphant. Kristen apparently cheated on Rob with her director from the Snow White and the Huntsman movie. But on the bright side, Miley Cyrus and Liam Hemsworth got engaged, and Taylor Swift found herself a new beau, Connor Kennedy. Now maybe she can stop writing those sappy love songs. This has been Caitlin Munoz, and now back to the studio.
See Speedo for homecoming needs. The Speedo store will be open for homecoming orders every day at 7:35, before school, during both lunches, and after school until 4. Get your orders early. The deadline is September 12th. FCCLA begins next week. The first FCCLA meeting will be held on Tuesday, September 11th, from 3:40 to 4:20 in room 2027 of the Freshman Center. Refreshments will be served. Here's your Student Council news. Homecoming shirts and dance tickets will be sold September 10th through the 14th in all lunches and after school in room 406. Shirts are $10 and tickets are $8.
Now that summer has ended, usually the teachers ask how their student summer was. This time we asked the teachers how they spent the last couple of days preparing themselves for a new school year. This is what they had to say.
I moved classrooms this year, so it was a good 2 days of coming in here and moving all my furniture and all my stuff.
We were here a week and one day earlier than the students, so, and then I had to come in on a Saturday to do some extra stuff for myself to get my room looking pretty.
A lot of time goes into preparing for the school year. I would say I probably spent 4 or 5 hours trying to get my classroom ready, and then I spent many hours, 20 to 30 hours, trying to get materials and lessons and things like that ready for my classroom.
Every year, I look forward to all the freshmen coming in that I get, and then I actually work with them for all the 4 years, so I look forward to seeing them develop through the 4 years that I have them.
This year is my first year teaching some of the courses like calculus, so I expect to have quite a bit of fun and excitement learning kind of the ins and outs of those classes with my students.
I look forward to the changes we're doing a lot more planning as teachers, as groups, like planning with all the English 1 teachers, English 2 teachers. So I look forward to that. It seems that we really all are on the same page now, and we have awesome things coming up for these kids.
Now that you know the time and effort that teachers put into you for your success, next time a teacher asks you, what have you done this summer? Ask yourself, what have they done for you? This has been Catherine Huerta.
Here's some BPA news. BPA will be having their first meeting of the year on September 10th in the varsity cafeteria at 4:30 p.m. All students are welcome. Fields of Faith. The Fields of Faith will be held on September 19th at 6 p.m. on Matador Field. This year's special guest is Christian hip-hop singer Tadashi. All are welcome to this free event. Also, See You at the Pole will be held September 26th at 7:30 a.m. at the flagpole in front of the school.
Welcome back, SHS, to a new year and a new volleyball team. Last Tuesday, the Lady Mats conquered Floresville with scores of 25-22, 25-21. We got the scoop on some varsity players to see what their expectations are for this season.
A lot of fun, a lot of wins, and just very, very good volleyball. Well, all the girls are super fun, and we act like a family, and we go crazy in the locker room, and it's just a lot of fun, and we have a lot of positive team members, so it should be a great year.
We expect the best. Like, we expect us to win all of our games, like, do the best that we can, give 150% every time.
Well, we have Coach Stanley, and that's really a big difference, and she's great. We've done multiple different drills, and every practice is different.
Having Coach Stanley as a coach is absolutely amazing. Like, I couldn't ask for a better coach, and her positive attitude just brings us all closer together.
I want to go to state, state, state.
We're looking forward to another great season and expect a lot of our Lady Matadors. The Mats are back, SHS, and they've come to win. This has been Keegan Ross reporting. Now here's Chastity with our MC updates.
The boys will be taking on New Braunfels Unicorns away. The Lady Matadors hosted a tournament. On Tuesday, they played Roosevelt High School, and today they take on Hayes. Good luck, Matadors. This has been Chastity Polanco reporting.
And that's it for today's MatCast. This has been Kelsey Bennett.
And Brittany Miner.
Welcome back, SHS!